أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب والنبي المصطفى صلوات الله عليه وآله on one mule until the turn came for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to walk. So one, they rotate, they alternate. So Abu Lubab al-Munzir, Sayyidina Amir al-Mu'minin Ali, they said, Ya Rasulullah, you stay, we'll give you our turn and we will walk. He's the best of the creation after all, you want to make him walk? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them this. He says, Ma antuma bi aqdari ala al-mashi minni, both of you do not have a stronger effort or a stronger motive to walk more than me. And I am not less in need of the reward than you. Giving us the highest example of what participation means. Positive participation and contribution. A man comes to a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Hakim sahih al-hadith, hadith sahih. According to Al-Hakim rahimahullah, where he starts ترعد فرائصه. So he starts shaking when he sees him. Shaking. قال له هون عليك. Take it easy. He sees the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He's overtaken by the glorious majesty of his presence صلوات الله عليه وسلم. لكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم in a very easy way. هون عليك. إنما أنا ابن امرأة من قريش كانت تأكل القديد. I am simply the son of a woman from Quraysh who used to eat dried meat in Mecca. Take it easy. To slow us down. To make us realize that in order for us, because we don't want to talk about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from as fairy tales. No, no. We want to talk about him so we can try to follow his footsteps. That's the whole point. So we can take him as an uswa to us. Well, you know what happened. He went to the cave. Jibreel alayhi salam comes and tells him, Iqra. You all know this, the whole story. Bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. He goes to Khadija radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Khadija, ummul mu'mineen, your mother. All of your mother. And I always ask my fellow brothers and sisters how much they know about their mother. And how much they mention their mother Khadija, especially Khadija, the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, إني رزقت حبها المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم says, I was given the rizq of her love. So much that way after her death, he would go give this whenever he offers a sacrifice. Give this to the friends of Khadija. Give this to the people of Khadija. Give this to this Khadija so that Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha says, I'll never mention Khadija in front of him again. He comes back and he says, Dathiruni. Dathiruni, Dathiruni, cover me. Cover me. Qawlan thaqeela. This is a message. Jibreel comes to him. With the next ayah. Ya ayyuhal mudathir, qum fanzir. Oh, you who is covered. It's time to do da'wah. There's no time for sleep anymore. There's no time for rest anymore. قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Stand up and give da'wah. And really the Prophet, فِعْلًا النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ stood up and start going out calling people saying, يَا قَوْمْ قُولُوا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ تُفْلِحُوا. Say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You will succeed. Soon as he said that, now the answers were not in matters of words, but the answers were in stones and pebbles at him, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So much that his not only his feet bled, they put ditches on the road, they did all these things. Lakinna al-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that did not put him down. When he falls and the blood is covering, he will stand up. But you know who he would see in front of his face? He would see this big heart. الوجه البشوش, the beautiful face, and he would see the overwhelming mercy of Khadija al-Kubra radiyallahu ta'ala anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, standing next to him, bringing him food and bringing him water, wiping out his blood and taking care of his wounds. She was right there next to him, calling him Ya Nabi Allah. Wallahi la yukhzik Allahu abada. Oh, Prophet of Allah, by Allah, Allah will never put you down. When we look at what they said about him and what they still say, As-Sadiq al-Amin became As-Sahir al-Kadhab, wal-Iyadhu Billah. Al-Aqil al-Razin became Al-Majnoon. Noon, Allah defends him. Noon wal-Qalam. وما يسطرون ما أنت بنعمة ربك بمجنون. You are not مجنون. يقول الذين كفروا لست مرسلا. Those who are kuffar, they say you are not a مرسل. You are not رسول. What does Allah say? بسم الله. Does the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم have to say anything? No. إن الله يدافع عن الذين آمنوا. Allah defends those who believe. What does Allah say? ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين. Invokes Yasin, wal Quran, you are amongst the messengers. Yatim becomes a threat because those people were having businesses off of tyranny and greed and slavery to people. Not only physical slavery, but intellectual and economical slavery. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to free people, to give people that freedom and liberty and the right for the pursuit of happiness. To give them hope, growth, and opportunity. And therefore, when we talk about the trials that the Prophet ﷺ was faced with, what can we say and where can we start? But as I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me and tawfiq to learn from some of his trials, most importantly, extending the mercy. And I'll finish with this, if I may. Al-Hadith fi Muslim. Ja'a Amr ibn Tufayl. Or Tufayl ibn Amr, afwan anas. Al-Dawsi. He came to him after the Prophet ﷺ sent him to give guidance to the people. What did he say? Qala ya Rasulullah, inna Dawsan asat wa abat. Fad'u Allah alayha. Ya Rasulullah, you sent me to Daws, my tribe, and they rejected me. And they refused Islam. So, oh Rasulullah, make dua against them. Imagine if this is one of us, someone who did you wrong, and you have the power actually to retaliate. Because nowadays we want remote control. Anyone who I don't like, check. This. As hadith says, قَالُوا فَهَلَكَتْ دَوْسِ. The Sahaba says, now if the Prophet ﷺ makes dua, Daws will be perished. You know what the Prophet ﷺ said? قَالَ اللَّهُمَّ اهْدِ دَوْسًا وَأْتِي بِهِمْ. اللَّهُمَّ اهْدِ دَوْسًا وَأْتِي بِهِمْ. Twice. Oh Allah, guide the tribe of Daws and bring them peacefully. Oh Allah, guide the tribe of Daws. This is what we can take as an extension of the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.